Hey guys, how's it going? Laura with Garden Answer. In today's video, I want to talk about air plants, kind of a beginner's guide on how to take care of them and what they even are. The other day, I was having a conversation with one of my friends, and I mentioned air plants because I had just picked up a couple more to bring home, and she was like, so what are air plants exactly? And I thought, you know what, there's probably a lot of people out there that don't really know what they are or how to take care of them. So that's what I want to do today, is just kind of share with you guys everything I've learned throughout the years taking care of them, starting off with what they are. So air plants are perennial tropical plants that live in areas where it stays warm year-round and with very high humidity. So in non-tropical climates, like the area where I live, where it's zone 5, it's very cold in the winter, we typically see them as house plants, and that's how we take care of them. They're actually super interesting plants because they grow differently than any other plant that I'm familiar with anyway. They don't require soil to grow. In fact, you don't need soil to have them grow. In their native environment, you see them usually anchored onto other plants, which makes them what's called an epiphyte. So epiphytes are plants that grow anchored onto another plant. They're not parasitic though, so they might root into the side of a tree, but they're not deriving any of their moisture or nutrients from that tree. They're actually soaking in all of their moisture and nutrients through the air, through their foliage. So their foliage soaks it in from whatever is surrounding them in the air, and that's why they're called air plants. There are hundreds of air plants, and there's not a huge variance in terms of color. In fact, many of them are kind of along this gray-green color. They have very different structures and textures though. And it's interesting to me because finer-leaved air plants, like something like this right here, these are actually suited for more moist, wet climates, as opposed to these strappier, thicker-leaved air plants are better for drought areas. There are some air plants, though, that have very beautiful colors, from like a smoky purple to this really pretty bright red on this Abdita red form. I mean, check this one out. It's so gorgeous. We used this in a video that we shot a couple of years ago on how to mount air plants. So that's pretty much an overview of what air plants are. So let's just jump right into how to take care of them. And this is all based on air plants as house plants, because that's the only way I know how to take care of them, because they're not native to the environment I live in, do not live in a tropical place. So let's start with what kind of light they like. Generally, they want bright indirect light, but if you want them inside and you don't have a super bright area, they do okay under fluorescent lighting in a home or an office situation. If you have an area where there's more direct light, you just want to keep in mind that you're going to have to water them more often, because the more direct light they get, the more depleted their moisture levels will get. Next up, let's talk about watering. And there's basically two schools of thought on how to water. The first school of thought is on misting, and misting them often. Now, if you live in a really humid climate, you might be able to get away with that because they can soak in some of that moisture from the air. So they are getting some water from the air as well as mist from you. The other way to do it is to submerge them about once or twice a week in water for like 20 to 30 minutes and let them soak in the water that way. That's the way I have the most success doing it, because it's really dry here. If I were to do the misting route, I'd have to mist them every single day. And let's face it, I'm not gonna remember to do that. I don't know about you guys. That's a lot of maintenance. I'd rather do a once a week soak without having to worry about misting them all the time. When I give them a soak, I submerge them fully in water for 20 to 30 minutes. Then I pull them out, kind of tap off or shake off any excess water, and then set them upside down to dry on a towel somewhere. And I usually let them sit for several hours that way, let that water drip away from the crown of the plant. That's the whole point of letting them dry upside down, because you don't want the water running into the crown, settling there, and eventually rotting the plant out. If your air plant is in bloom, you want to make sure not to submerge your plant. You want to rinse it instead, because the blooms are very delicate and they cannot take being submerged in water for any amount of time. That type of watering I do once a week as a general rule of thumb, but I will up it maybe to twice a week when it's really hot out in the summer, it's really dry, or I might give them some supplemental misting in between their once a week watering. But you can kind of tell when an air plant needs to be watered. When they're full of water, their leaves will be very stiff, a little bit darker color. When they're getting dry and they're telling you they need a drink, you can tell, because they'll be a softer kind of texture, they'll be a lighter color. Sometimes their leaves will roll or wrinkle, and that's when you can tell that they need a drink. Temperature is next, and that one is pretty easy. I treat air plants pretty much like I treat my tender succulents and cacti. They can be out in the summertime, but they need to be in a place where they don't get any afternoon sun. They need to be protected from any harsh weather. You do have to keep an eye on watering a little bit more often if you have them out in the summertime. They do need to come in for the winter. So kind of a range of temperatures for air plants is about 50 degrees Fahrenheit to 90 degrees Fahrenheit. That's where they are the happiest. Grooming and maintenance is pretty easy on air plants. They're super low maintenance. You might notice the lower leaves of the air plant starting to dry and shrivel a little bit, and that's totally normal, especially if they're growing or if they're trying to acclimate to a new spot. Just gently pull them off the base of the plant and they're good to go. The plant will keep on growing. Don't worry about it. You also might notice that some of the tips will kind of look a little bit dry. That's also normal. It could be a sign that you might need to up the water just a tiny bit, but it just kind of happens every once in a while with air plants, and you can easily go in with a pair of clippers or scissors and cut them off, and make sure that when you do that to cut them kind of at a point. That way they blend in with the rest of the foliage of your plant. Next up is fertilizing, and it's not 100% necessary to fertilize your air plants, but like with all other plants, it helps keep them really healthy and it can help promote blooming and reproduction, so it's a kind of a good idea. So you can get a fertilizer that's specific to Tillandsias, which is the botanical name for air plants, or bromeliads. Those are really great specific fertilizers for this plant, but you can also use a regular houseplant fertilizer. That's what I do. I use Espoma's indoor organic fertilizer, but I do use it at a quarter strength. So I just add that to the water that I'm gonna submerge them in once a month. Now I wanna talk about blooms really quick. So air plants are perennials that can last for several years, but they only bloom once in their lifetime, which makes it a really neat experience when they come into bloom. They can be really bright colors, really striking. They can also be very fragrant. It's just a really neat thing. I always loved it when my air plants came into bloom. I had to take pictures and text them to all of my family members to show them the blooms on my air plants because it's just so incredible. The thing about those is that they can last from several days up to several months, depending on what variety of air plant you have. And they'll also bloom at different times, depending on the variety you have. But typically, they'll come into bloom between midwinter and midsummer. The next point is on reproduction. And right about the time that the air plant starts to bloom, it'll start to reproduce. And so it'll produce these little pups or babies right off the base of the mother plant. And you can either leave them on the mother plant and they'll turn into what's called a clump. So it's just a clump of air plants all sticking together, or you can separate them. It's very easy to do. You do wanna make sure that the pup is about a third the size of the mother before you separate it. You can gently pull them apart at the base, or you can pull them apart a little bit and then use something sharp like a razor blade or scissors to clip them apart. And then that baby plant will turn into another mother plant and it'll grow and produce pups of its own. And the very last thing I want to talk about is where you can put air plants. And you can basically put them anywhere where they will receive adequate light and adequate moisture. So that might mean that you have them laying on a table or desk somewhere. Maybe you have them in a glass terrarium that always looks really pretty, or you can mount them. There's all kinds of different wonderful ways that you can mount air plants that are really neat to look at. In fact, we did a video a few years back on how to mount, it's just several ideas on how to mount air plants. We will include the link down below. I cannot attest to the quality of the video because it's been a while. A couple of things you want to keep in mind. You cannot put air plants on anything copper. So I brought this one out here to show you. This is an air plant that Gardener Supply sent me a couple of years ago. It's in a copper, faux copper sphere. If this was real copper, it would kill the air plants. Copper and air plants do not mix. So just keep that in mind. So you can use things that look copper, but they can't be real copper. And you can also use several different types of glue to mount your air plants, like E6000 hot glue. You can use liquid nails. You just wanna make sure that it doesn't touch the foliage of the plant. You just wanna adhere or glue the roots of the plant to whatever you're mounting it to. So that's pretty much it, you guys. I hope this video was helpful to you. If it was, or if you have a friend that you think would benefit from this information, please make sure to tag them or share this video with them. And as always, thank you so much for watching our video. Make sure you're subscribed to our channel, leave a like down below, and we will see you in the next video. Bye.